lenge siden sist?
I New York. In New York war es, glaube ich, noch mehr. Das war mir so krass. Aber hier in Deutschland? Nee, oder?
Leute, wir sind die größte Demo, die dieses Land jemals gegen Kohle gesehen hat! Now I'm very excited to announce a very special guest. A very, very inspiring person. We're very proud to have her here. Her name is Kathy Kitchener. I hope I pronounce it right. And Kathy comes from very far. She comes from the Pacific Island state, Marshall Islands, which is one of the states that's especially endangered by the rising sea levels and climate change impacts. And Kathy will present us a poem now, if I'm informed right. She's here with a group, and maybe you met them already, the very inspiring people from all over the Pacific, which are called Pacific Climate Warriors. And I personally feel lots and lots of respect because of their very great attitude they're coming with and their great message, which is we're not drowning, we're fighting. So please, everybody, give us a very warm hand and a very warm welcome to Kathy.
Climate change. We're experiencing more floodings and the worst droughts we've ever seen in the world, and it's as a direct result of the coal industry, which is why we need to end the fossil fuel industry now, and that's why we're here today. So thank you all. So the poem I'm going to be sharing with you all today is a poem that I wrote to my daughter. She's 7 months old at the time. Her name is Mata Felipina. And this was a poem that I wrote for the movement and to inspire us all to continue to fight. And it's also about the message about not drowning and fighting. Dear Mata Felipina, you are a 7-month-old sunrise of gummy smiles. You are bald as an egg and bald as a Buddha. Your thighs that are thunder, shrieks that are lightning, so excited for bananas, hugs, and our morning walks along the lagoon. Dear Mata Felipina, I want to tell you about that lagoon. That lucid, sleepy lagoon lounging against the sunrise. Men say that one day that lagoon will devour you. They say it will gnaw at the shoreline, chew at the roots of your breadfruit trees, gulp down rows of seawalls, and crunch through your island's shattered bones. They say you, your daughter, and your granddaughter too will wander, rootless, with only a passport to call home. Dear Mata Felipina, don't cry. Mommy promises you, no one is going to devour you. No greedy whale of a company sharking through political seas. No backwater bullying of businesses with broken morals. No blindfolded bureaucracy gonna push this mother ocean over the edge. No one's drowning, baby. No one's moving. No one's losing their homeland. No one's gonna become a climate change refugee. Or should I say no one else? To the Carteret Islanders of Papua New Guinea and to the Tara Islanders of the Solomon Islands, I take this moment to apologize to you. We are drawing the line here because we, baby, are going to fight. Your mommy, daddy, Bua, Jima, your country, and your president too, we will all fight. And even though there are those hidden behind platinum titles who like to pretend that we don't exist, who like to pretend that the Marshall Islands, Tuvalu, Kiribati, Maldives, Typhoon Haiyan in the Philippines, and the floods of Algeria, Colombia, Pakistan, and all the earthquakes and hurricanes and tidal waves didn't exist? Still, there are those who see us, hands reaching out, fists raising up, banners unfurling, megaphones booming, and we are canoes blocking coal ships. We are the radiance of solar villages. We are the fresh, clean soil of the farmer's past. We are petitions blooming from teenage fingertips. We are families biking, recycling, reusing, engineers dreaming, designing, building, artists painting, dancing, writing, and we are spreading the word. And there are thousands out on the the streets, marching hand in hand, chanting for change now. And they're marching for you, baby. They're marching for us. Because we deserve to do more than just survive. We deserve to thrive. Dear Mata Pellegrina, won't let you down. You'll see. Thank you.